All right, we're up on at the beginning of the trailhead for Jackson Trail, which is just right back there at that yellow gate. We're up on the top of the mountain ridge. And as you can see, they got all kinds of transmitting antennas. I mean, a ton of stuff. Receiving, microwaves, dishes. Here's the giggles. But yeah, I guess, yeah, this is the Jackson Trail, and we're gonna do, I don't know, somewhere 4 to 6 miles, not quite sure yet. We haven't done this one yet. But I think we hike down maybe a couple miles, 3 miles or something, then we come back on the Mid-State Trail, which kind of runs parallel to this. I'm guessing over that way, maybe. Somewhere. And end up back at our truck, which is parked on the other side of the highway at a vista called, what was it called?
I don't remember.
Joe Hayes or something?
Yeah, some senator.
Yeah, you can see. The dishes in, it says American Tower on that building. You can hear the high voltage, or maybe that's air conditioning, I don't know. All right, well, I'll keep you on here for a second. Get into the woods. Says to be careful, there are lots of rocks. Where there's lots of rocks, there's snakes. And we'll be keeping a good eye out for those. Hopefully, safely see some timbers. All right, here's the trail, and we'll see you in a bit. All right, we're still on the Jackson Trail and towards the beginning, and just want to show you, this is a pretty cool, different trail surface than we've experienced. Just all rock. Which we knew ahead of time, but it's still kind of wild once you get here and see. I mean, look at that. And again, it's blazed blue. Quiet, just a woods ridgeline topography or whatever, where the leaves haven't hardly come out yet at all. Beautiful day. Yeah, a lot of bugs, and we hear some birds and stuff. Hey, what do we got here? Those are the, what do we call them, keystone caterpillars. There's some more. I seen them all over somewhere the other day on the highway. All right, we'll see in a bit. All right, some more on the Jackson Trail here. Just wanted to show you how technical this is. I don't know if I'd call it super technical because it's still flat, but yeah, you gotta watch your step. This kind of trail that ankle problems could be had pretty easily. That's the path, I guess, right? Yeah, that's the path. It's crazy. Cool. All right, just wanted to, oh, there's the bubble bee. Like stirring up the leaves. He's flying so low. Yeah, we got lots and lots of this. Probably the whole trail, I'm assuming. See in a bit. Fire pit we found. It's pretty cool. Just clear up on the ridge and walk over here. I think we got a vista. Oh, get down on my knees to get under that. My pack. Now this is actually, you can kind of see, not sure if there's a vista up here or not. Blue blaze. Wow, it's freaking crazy. I think we might get a better view over here. But yeah, there's basically I don't know if this one's directly related to a glacier or if a glacier was nearby and this was caused by the climate around a glacier. Let's see if I can get over here. All right, here we go. David's Vista. 1923 to 1997. David Kaufman. David's Vista. That, my friends, is David's Vista. That is Nikki Giggles. And this is a crazy boulder field. You getting pictures?
Yeah.
Let me just carry your phone in your pocket. Make it easier. Oh, you got the nice camera. Sweet. Can't imagine trying to traverse across this. That's nuts. And again, see way across the valley. Oh yeah. All right. Yeah, this is a good hike. Just wear good shoes. See you in a bit. All right, we'll take you along for a minute and let's just show you again. That's the trail right there. How technical it is. And again, we're up on the ridge line. That's why it's so rocky. Not bad, you just gotta constantly stare down and watch where you're stepping. Oh yeah, unless you're like on the rail trail. Somewhere you can kind of blindly look around while you're... But here, yeah, you, if you want to look around, you pretty much need to stop. Hello. Hello, Nikki.
Hi.
Yeah, it makes it even a little harder to do. I got my hiking sticks in my hand and I'm trying to hike while holding the camera, but I won't do it too much longer here. Yeah, I'll take you up here. There's looks like another boulder field maybe up here. Or a vista, I don't think so though. Yeah, we get to climb across another little boulder field. Little B. Again, good shoes. I got Salomon X4 comp, whatever the heck they are. Cole's wearing her Merrill, those Moabs?
Moab.
Yeah, Merrill Moab. Hers are better for the ankles. I should have worn my Merrills, but my Merrills bother my feet. And I like the Solomons. They're trail runners. All right, take a break here. We got to climb down there. So I got to be careful. See? All right, another boulder field. Nicole walking through here. Just to give you an idea of the technical aspects of it. Just gotta watch, like I said, your footing. This is actually the path right there. It gets better every now and then, but for the most part, this whole trail is walking on rocks to some degree or another. But you see, like I said, right here, it's not so bad. Again, we're still on the ridgeline, which we are the whole way, I'm pretty positive. Alright. Alright, hiking along, and bam! Another beautiful view. Humongous rocks. Let's see if we can get up here, show you what we got going on. Wow. Yep, this is another glacially related boulder field. That's our trail, by the way. Just to show you what it's like hiking across a ridgeline. I'll have to read up on this one. Like I said, some of them, of these boulder fields, were deposited directly by glaciers coming in and then retreating and leaving behind this, basically, destruction, if you want to call it that. Or a glacier was very near here and it creates a very dry atmosphere climate, and that climate basically wears everything down, exposes the rock, then cracks the rock, then moisture gets in and freezes and refreezes and cracks it, and eventually you got this left over. And it's all over Pennsylvania and various areas, including where we live. Again, we're the Jackson Trail is pretty close to Bullsburg near State College, about 45 minutes or so from our house, maybe an hour, but yeah. So yeah, that's what we got. You got Nikki over here smiling, getting ready to take a picture. And yeah, triple blaze of white. I have no idea what that is about. It's not really even a proper blaze, so I don't know. Something else. There's a white one up there. Is the Mid-States white? I kind of thought that. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, we got this beautiful vista.
That's just the mark.
You can see another massive boulder field that we gotta cross. We gotta stay on the back side, but a little arduous here for a little bit. All right. I'm gonna say this trail is seriously a rockstickle course. It's freaking nuts, man. Highly recommend you are in good shape and got good equipment, because look how long this goes. Great view. But yeah, we got to cross all that. You can see the blue blaze on the rock right there, and it looks like it just goes on and on. All right, this is very difficult. This is what we're coming across all the way back through there. So again, if you're hiking this Jackson Trail, just be ready. You'll probably not do it with a camera in your hand. Ugh. It's freaking nuts. again. So we came from way back over there. We got about one or two more big fields like that. Like this. All right, I gotta use my sticks. See ya. All right, we're on our way back on the Jackson Trail, but I just want to point out, and I already filmed this vista and boulder field, but there's probably about a half a dozen of these clear down at the far end of the trail down that way. That's actually a lot more dangerous, I would say. This one isn't bad at all to cross, but again, like I said, I would say there's probably a half a dozen of these that you got to walk across that type of boulder field for a good, I don't know, some of them are a couple hundred yards, I suppose. 100 yards, maybe. See ya. All right. That's a black rat. First snake of the year, scared to shoot out of us. It rattled, it used its tail in the leaves. It doesn't have an actual rattle. Whew, that scared the crap out of me, man. I actually about fell. He's doing it now. You see the tail back there? I hope you can see that on the video as Nicole gets closer. Again, I don't know how well this will come out, but I'm gonna stop this so I can get a, you can see him, he's pretty good. One, probably close to 3 feet of stretch out. Pretty sure it's a black rat. I'm not sure how to tell a racer, but boy, he looks like he's ready to go at something. He looks mad. There's our first guy of the year on the Jackson Trail, south of State College. Be back in a little bit. All right, just wanted to point out some of the different areas of walking on the Jackson Trail. That this is inside the hemlocks. Let me get back and get you a better view. So it'll be just this kind of environment, nice, cool, and shady, and not too bad. Sorry, the sun's blocking that. All right, it's a good hike. I think we're at, yep, there's a fire pit. Somebody's got a camp set up here. Let me show you this. Got a nice log bench, fire pit. Probably use any of these trees for hammocks. Hammock camping's the way to go. Although you got plenty of room for a tent right there. That's probably about the only good flat spot, and it'd still be at a little bit of an angle. All right, continuing our hike up. Gonna get rocky. All right, hiking along, and we came across this. I'll read it to you, but it's a medallion embedded in the rock. You can't possibly pull it up. Looks like other people have tried to pry it, but it says U.S. Coast Geodetic Survey Triangulation Station, and it says Washington, or write to the director, Washington, for information. It says something about a fine or imprisonment for destructing this marker. Tussie, 1935 to 1939. Pretty cool. I want to look that stuff up later. All right, we're coming to the end of our 5 mile Jackson Trail hike. It's just down this way. I'll probably pause it and then show you again, but got these towers and microwaves. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 towers up here. Hold on. All right, we are finishing our hike. Good workout, man. Good leg workout, I should say. But anyway, there's a sign. 5K, 3.2 miles. Yeah, we were close. Yeah, we should have noted that earlier. That's the trail. It goes right beside that white building, clear up there, whitish green. That's where the trail head starts. So if you're looking at this to start it, you're watching this YouTube video, you'll see this sign. Just go 3 point, actually right about 3 miles even, we turned around at the 2.5 mile mark. It gets pretty technical and we were worried about time. Plus we weren't positive where the end was. Now we know. That's it. You gotta cross this road. You got good parking right over there. They got a beautiful vista right there and a big sign. I don't know if you can see it straight right there. That brown sign across the road shows you all the trails in the area and kind of a map. I don't think it has distances, but it's still pretty cool. So again, you're going to park over there. You're going to cross here and you're going to see that yellow gate and you're going to hike up between all those towers and follow the blue blaze and have fun. See you next time. And here's that sign. Here, point to that. There's the Jackson Trail. So you'll start there. Follow your way up to there. And the Mid-State starts there, but we just turned around and went back. You can do a loop.